A very good morning, my dear students. So once again we are here and with the same topic. The topic is lines and angles. You know very well what is a line and what are angles. What are lines and what are angles? Clear? Now if I draw like this two fixed point, this is called line segment. Clear? This is called line segment. Let me do once again. If I draw this two fixed point, this is called line segment. But if I draw like this and if I make it like this, the line segment is no more a line segment, it is a line because it has no end points. Clear? So what is a line? Line is a set of points. Line is a set of points which are placed very very close to each other and it extends. Okay, and it extends endlessly in both the directions. Endlessly in both the directions. Okay, now that is called a line. It should be straight. It goes straight endlessly or in the same direction. Okay, but opposite to each other. That is called a line. What is the angle? When two line segments meet, the common point. Here is the common point. There we get an angle. Clear? So we studied many types of angles. Yesterday we studied about supplementary angles, complementary angles, then we studied about adjacent angles, then vertically opposite angles. So based on this, today we will be doing some questions. That is question number 14. Here in this question number 14, what they have done, they have combined two concepts together. For example, if I say vertically opposite angle, that you know very well what is a vertical opposite angle. Let me make a small recap on this. If I say what are supplementary angles, sum of two angles, when we add sum of two angles, when we add two angles, if the answer is 180 degree, it is called supplementary angles. Now if we add two angles, if the answer is 90 degree, it is called complementary angles. Remember, I am not writing, please try to remember, this is called these two angles, when we add it becomes supplementary angles, or you can say that it forms a linear pair. That's what we did yesterday also. When we add two angles, if it becomes 90 degree or a right angle, then that means these two angles are complementary angles, or you can say this is complement of this or this is complement of this. Let me write one example here. Suppose 30 and 60. This is 30 here. 30 is complement of 60, 60 is complement of 30. In this case, suppose if I write 120 here and 60 here, that means 60 is complement of 120 and 120 is the complement of, supplement of 60. Let me repeat once again. 60 is the supplement of 120 or 120 is the supplement of 60. So they are called supplementary angles. Now what are obtuse angles? Obtuse angle which is more than 90 degree, which is more than 90 degree, it is called obtuse angle. Clear? Then after that, we also studied about adjacent angles. What are adjacent angles? Let me take the example of this. If I draw a line, now these two angles are adjacent angles. So what do we see? They share the common vertex. Clear? Common vertex here and the common arm. So such angles are called adjacent angles. After that, we did vertically opposite angle. What are vertically opposite angles? Suppose if I draw two line segments this way or two lines and we find that we get two angles opposite to each other. Suppose this is one angle, the other angle is this. So that means these two angles are opposite to each other. These two angles are opposite to each other. These two opposite angles are called vertically opposite angles. Clear? So this is what we did in our last class. Clear, my dear students? So what I'll be doing from question 14, I'll be taking some of the parts from here. Then I'll make you understand how to do this question. Now in this question, as I told you, as I was telling you, they will combine two concepts. One concept is obtuse. Then they will say obtuse vertically opposite. See, obtuse vertically opposite. What do you mean by this? obtuse means more than 90 degree but less than 180 degree. Vertically opposite means opposite to each other. So which are those angles? So we have to do this kind of questions. Okay, so let me draw the figure first, then we'll proceed with the question. Question number 14. One more thing, my dear student, please keep the book with you, and when I'm teaching you, your book should be in front of your eyes. Then only you will find it easy to understand. Okay, I'm drawing a line here. This is one line. This is another. Sorry, this is another line. Then this point is over here. They have given arrow. That means it is a line here. This is a line. This is a line. Then after that, they have written, this is A, then this is question number 14. This is A, this is B, then they have written C, then they have written D, again I am making small arrow here, then this is E. Now, the very first question is, find out obtuse vertically opposite angle. Let me write it here, obtuse vertically opposite angle. I am writing in short because of lack of space. Obtuse vertically opposite angle. This is, I have written in short. This symbol stands for angle. Okay, this symbol stands for angle. Clear? Now, what is that? The very first thing you have to understand, what do you mean by obtuse? Obtuse means more than 90 degree. Now, which angle can you see more than 90 degree? This angle I can say easily. Let me draw this. This angle. What is the opposite to this? The opposite to this is this angle. Don't mind, my dear student, the arc has gone from this vertically. Don't mind for that. Now, can you see these two angles, angle AOD, this angle is angle AOD and this angle is angle BOC, clear? Now, angle AOD and angle BOC are obtuse vertically opposite angle, clear? This was the first part, alright. Now, the second part is adjacent complementary angles. Adjacent means next to each other, immediately next to each other. What are those two angles? Those two angles are angle EO. I can see this angle EOA and then yes, angle EOA, then angle AOB. Look at this angle. Let me use another sketch pen. This angle EOA, this angle, I am putting with the red color, I hope it is visible there. And angle AOB, this angle. Angle EOA, angle AOB. What are these two angles? They form 90 degree. They are complementary angles. Alright. They are complementary angles. So this angle is angle EOA and this angle is angle AOB. So they form complementary angles. Clear? So answer for the second part is angle EOA and angle EOA and angle AOB. Clear? Okay. Now the third part. Equal supplementary angles. Supplementary angle means 180 degree. So what is that? So we have to find out where is 180 degree forming here. Can I say this EOB? Look at this. EOB is forming a 180 degree. Then can I say that can I say that? Yes. Can I say that EOD? See here. Can I say that EOD? EOB and EOD. They are forming supplementary angles. EOD plus EOB plus EOD, we are getting 180 degree. Have you understood? So here in this case, we have to take two angles. Two angles we have to take. Alright. Let me start. Let me say once again. The first part was vertically obtuse vertically opposite angle. Means we have to see this angle. This angle is opposite to this. Second was adjacent complementary angles. Means these two angles are complementary to each other. So therefore answer is EOA and AOB. And the last one which I taught you just now was equal supplementary angles. Means both the angles should be equal and it should make 180 degree. So this angle plus this angle. Alright. Clear? So just go through this question. Only I have taken only one question. And one part I have given as a homework. I have already done the study material. I'll be giving it to you. So just go through it once again and try to apply the concepts. Okay, my dear students, I think this is enough for today. Thank you.